same, I think, and head back upstairs and see what they come up with.
Yeah.
In this area, like, that is about, listen mate, you can do more than that, we know you can.
What did you hear that then?
What was it, Steve?
Just a ch-
yeah.
The noises that we heard in that pool room, it did seem that we all experienced some sort of audio anomaly in that room at the same time.
Yeah. There's been a few of those. I heard a few over there before as well, yeah.
Oh, did you hear that? Ooh. Is that any of us?
Do you know what? Wait, you thought leave me in here with the camera on my own for 5 minutes.
Okay.
Okay.
I reckon maybe on my own it might just have the courage to like do something naughty.
Like maybe there's possibly somebody even used to live here and stuff.
Right, yeah, yeah. Well, it could be just as much as it could be someone who worked at the tattoo place, you know what I mean? It's just, there's that many things.
There's been that many lines.
What the f- did you hear that? Like a moo come from there?
I did.
Come on, man. Alright, use that camera. You stay for 5 minutes.
Here you go.
Yeah, got it, Steve. Oh, thanks, man.
I decided to spend a little bit of time on my own downstairs in the pool room. The reason for this is there might be a chance that if there is something down there that is intelligent, might not like being crowded out by 4, 3, or 2 people.
Are you someone that lived here? In this building? Why do you stay here? What makes it so interesting and special for you? I mean, did you die here? Did you die in this building? Are you a fireman? I'm going to have to go soon and leave this room, but you know the others that come in here, can you put your hand on their shoulder and press it down like you did with mine? Is that something that happened to you? For the record, I think I heard a voice, male. Are you talking to me? I'm gonna go and leave you in peace.
Cheers,
Shell.
Okay. See you, Shell.
See you later.
Do you need another one?
See you, Steve.
Thank
you very much.
Okay.
See you later. Cheers,
bro. Shelley and Steve had to call it a night around this point. I'm sure they would have liked to have stayed longer, but the constraints of getting up and going for work sometimes can have quite a strain on investigators.
Right.
There's a voice recorder down in the middle of the table.
Right. Is it a flashing word? Hello, whoever's in here. There's going to be some flashes, okay?
Oh, that's all right.
Can you come and talk to us, please? It's just me getting Katie out.
Oh, I've got one here.
We'll put one at each end of the table, I suppose.
If one goes off random, you know, mobile phone or whatever, there's two of them going off, it gives you a bit more to go. A bit of an experiment, you've got to split your equipment up a bit.
You know, before they were saying that they're horrible room?
Mm.
Do you think that's because
You know, like when people get cellar fanatics, they go, well, it's horrible, like, yeah? Because it's like out of bounds normally in the house, isn't it? It's not somewhere you'd normally hang out.
Well, sort of because of the way the room feels as well. You like when you walk in, if somewhere's like damp and dark, I just feel something then.
What?
Like...
Whereabouts? Sit torture.
Jeez. Like, you see like there?
Yeah.
By the middle of the torch, so like a white light about the same size as the torch, like the centre of the torch. But it was like a misty white colour. And then like, because it was sort of through the corner of my eye, and I sort of looked at it, and I could see it until I like directly looked at it, and then it disappeared.
Cool. Good starter.
Mm-hmm.
Can you move the pool balls on the table? Wait, I shot the pool table, it's in there.
Hmm?
Shot the pool table. Got it in train set. Try that.
If you are here, can you come and light up this green light that's in front of me, please? Just try and pick up the grey box off the table.
Flashlight.
Alright.
Can you bang on the door or move on these lights or knock on the wall?
I decided to try out my usual experiment of knocking on a piece of wood or a wall, just to try and see if we can get a response that way. I tell you what, I'm going to knock. Can you knock back? We both heard what sounded like a response. Can you do that again?
What's your connection with this building? Can we ask you that? Is that alright? So these tiles run from the prelim.
I thought just after you asked that question, I thought I heard like a... like a yeah. But it was really... It was almost sort of echoey and really faint.
I thought, oh, what's in here?
Ooh. What?
Oh, God.
I can't see anything.
Ooh.
What?
The stairs, under the stairs.
Oh my God. Yeah, we had to look around and we noticed that there was a little hole in the wall. That would have been an old lane. It would have been steps because you can see how we're on a slope now, can't you?
You get the camera in there. Go and have a film around.
At this point, I kind of put on my explorer boots and sort of went for a look. I'm quite an inquisitive person, which I know is a posh word for nosy. There's the steps. It's kind of hard to see this guy, so...
We've got the window. Which you can't get on this camera because the fucking end's too big. That's why Liz has decided to go and get a smaller camera.
Yeah. Good.
Welcome, Lizzie.
Huh?
You got a small camera now?
I got mine on,
yeah. Yeah, we'll have a film in there. Do you want to...
So it should be right with the torch, actually.
Yeah, it should be okay, yeah.
I'm not sure how good this is going to turn out. But...
Someone's knocked out through, haven't they?